Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the basket weave portrait effect for version CC and later. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button and please remember to click like. Open a close-up photo of someone's face. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to crop our photo to a specific size and resolution. Open your crop tool. Open the crop preset list and click Width, Height, and Resolution. Type in 1000 pixels in the Width field and the Height field. Its resolution is 150 pixels per inch. Go to any of the corners and drag it in to size your image. This effect looks best when your subject is tightly cropped. To accept it, press Enter or Return twice or click the check mark at the top. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and replace it with another photo without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. By the way, we can make our thumbnails in the Layers panel bigger or smaller by clicking back on the same icon and clicking Panel Options. Presently, I have the largest size ticked. To consolidate space in the Layers panel, I'll tick the medium size. Once we click OK, our thumbnails are seen in the new size. We can zoom into our document incrementally by pressing Ctrl or Command and the plus key on our keyboard, or by pressing Ctrl or Command plus 0 to fill our canvas. Another way is to type in a percentage of its size here. Before we continue, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on our keyboard. To create the basket weave effect, we first need to make guidelines. To do this, go to View, Guides, and New Guide Layout. New Guide Layout was first introduced in Photoshop CC. If you don't see the guidelines, press Ctrl or Command H. Make the number of columns and rows 8 each, and the gutters 0.2 inches. If it's in centimeters, type in 0.5. All other fields should be empty. We'll make 4 copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J 4 times. If you need more room to see all the layers, just drag the Layers panel up. Make the bottom layer active. Go to View, and if Snap isn't checked, click it to make it active. Open the Rectangular Marquee tool and make sure the Add Selection icon is active. This adds selections as we make them. Place your cursor on the upper left corner of the top guideline and drag down a rectangular selection to the lower right corner of the wide column. Go to the bottom left corner of the next wide column and drag up another rectangular selection. Continue to add selections over all the wide columns, making sure you don't include the narrow columns. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selections next to the active layer. Make Layer 0, Copy 2 active. Place your cursor at the upper left corner of the top guideline and drag across a rectangular selection to the lower right corner of the top row. Continue to add selections over all the wide rows, avoiding the narrow rows. As before, click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selections next to the active layer. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Ctrl or Command click the top layer mask to make a selection of its shapes. Go to the bottom layer mask and press Ctrl Alt Shift on Windows or Command Option Shift on a Mac to add a selection that intersects the column shapes with the row shapes. Press Q on your keyboard to make the selection into a quick mask. Make the layer between the layer masks active and open the Paint Bucket tool. Place your cursor over the second empty box on the top row and click once to fill it. Skip a box and click the fourth one. Continue to click every other box on that row. In the second row from the top, click the second empty box from the right. Then click every other box in that row. Continue filling in every other box. Press Q to make the quick mask into a selection. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. As before, Control or Command click the layer mask of the rows to select their shapes, and go to the layer mask of the columns. Press Control Alt Shift on Windows or Command Option Shift on a Mac to intersect them. Press Q to make it into a quick mask and make the top layer active. Click the top left box to fill it in and continue to click every other box. Make it into a selection and then click the layer mask icon. Control or Command click the top layer mask to select its shapes. Invert the selection by pressing Control or Command Shift I. Go to the layer mask of the rows and press Control Alt Shift on Windows or Command Option Shift on a Mac to intersect it with the first selection. Make the second layer from the top active and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. We'll create a new layer below the bottom layer by making the bottom layer active and Control or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill it with black, and since our foreground color is black, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Double-click an empty area of the layer 0 copy to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. The blend mode is Linear Burn, the opacity is 10%, and the noise is 0. If the color box isn't black, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick black. The technique is softer, the spread is 0, and the size is 40 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Go to the FX symbol and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the outer glow effect onto the top layer. Presently, the outer glow of the top layer is creating shadows on all the columns instead of just the rows. To rectify this, we'll make the top layer into a clipping mask. This restricts or clips it to the layer below it. To do this, make the top layer active. Hover your cursor between the two layers, and when you see this icon, click it. Alternately, we could go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Double-click an empty area of the second layer from the top to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 7 pixels, and the soften is 0. Uncheck global light. Make the angle 90 degrees and the altitude 30 degrees. The gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is linear dodge. The color is white and the opacity is 10%. The shadow mode is linear burn. The color is black and its opacity is also 10%. Lastly, we'll add a bit of texture to our image. Make the top layer active and make a new layer above it. We'll fill it with white, and since our background color is white, press Control or Command plus Delete. Convert it into a smart object so we can change the texture at any time if we want. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. I'll choose Sandstone, but feel free to choose any of the others. The scaling is 100%, the relief is 4, and the light is from the top. Change the blend mode to Linear Burn and reduce its opacity to 50%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.